Ewing sarcoma is a very aggressive tumor. It's a very rare tumor, fortunately, but it's a very aggressive tumor that affects mainly children and young adults. And it's a tumor that occurs anywhere in the body, but in younger patients, it tends to be in the bones, so in the pelvis and in the long bones. In older patients, it can be bones, or it can also occur in soft tissues. So it's an unusual tumor, but it's a very aggressive tumor. So we need more research into Ewing sarcoma treatment because it's still associated with very, very high rates of morbidity and mortality. And what I mean by that is, although, like many childhood cancers, we've made a great advance in curing patients, the problem is that even for the patients who have that outlook, the treatment that they have to receive is so intensive that most of them are left with very significant health deficits later in their life as a consequence of the chemotherapy and the surgeries that they had to have for their disease. The other issue is that about a third of patients present where the disease has already spread, and we have very little to offer. We offer the same very intensive therapy for these patients, but invariably the disease comes back. We're tackling the problem really from two approaches in the lab. The first approach is to try to understand, where does this tumor come from? Because we really believe that to really understand what drives a tumor, we need to understand how it became a tumor in the first place. What was the normal cell that became a Ewing sarcoma cell instead of becoming a normal bone or a normal tissue? The other approach that we're taking is, if you already have the tumor, how can we better treat it? And so for those studies, we use already cancerous cells, Ewing sarcoma cells that we study, and we look at the genomics and the biologic pathways and the epigenomics, for people who are interested in the terms, and we look to see what's gone wrong in these cells, and can we then target any one or more of these pathways in a way that either kills the cell or prevents it from causing a new tumor or prevents it spreading to a new site. And all of that information that we learn in the lab, we then take those most promising discoveries and then move them through the next phase, and ultimately the goal is to get those discoveries into patients so that it changes the way we approach care and improves the outcome for patients with the disease.